Look, honey, you want some advice? Keep your paws off my underwear, okay?
So, you think you're a fan of the 2000s?
Can you hear me now?
Okay, Eminem, can you handle this?
Yeah, sure. I'm ready.
It's I Love the 2000s.
Can you dig it?
And this is 2002.
Hello.
The flicks.
Son of a bitch!
The fashions. The TV.
Have you seen The Wire?
The trends.
How's Shannon Elizabeth gonna play this hand?
The tunes.
Oh!
The totally amped year that gave us these radical questions. What's Serena's secret weapon?
What is her ass made of, heaven?
Where on earth is the axis of evil?
I just want someone to tell me who the bad guys are and then tuck me into bed with my binky.
And what's gotten into the zombies from 28 Days Later?
They run around like a bunch of coked out weirdos.
The answers to those questions plus the explanation for the Bennifer breakup.
In the Jenny from the Block video, he did two butt pats.
You can't do that.
You get one butt pat. Two, you're pushing it.
Because you're stoked to celebrate the 2000s.
Kids loved it.
Because you still rock that velour sweatsuit.
Wow.
Admit it.
Juicy.
This is 2002.
Sit back, relax, enjoy the show.
I hear about you surfing the Pipe Masters. It's a surfing contest, not a drowning contest.
Forget Endless Summer. Forget Point Break. Forget Shia LaBeouf as a talking surfing penguin. Blue Crush is the best surfing movie ever.
Now we all know summertime is a bummer with no duckets. Honeys want money exposed like their tummy is.
Girls get in little bikinis and they go surfing. I've actually never watched it with the volume on.
I saw it in the theater twice.
I remember liking it, liking the girl power in it.
Kate Bosworth, in her first starring role, she's got one blue eye, one kind of green-brown eye. She plays a badass surfer chick.
I don't mind girls that can charge pipe. You think you can surfer for real?
Well, I dated Juju. I guess I can do anything, huh?
She used to be this wunderkind surfer girl, then she had a bad accident. Because pipe's very dangerous. It's a widowmaker, bruh.
The day of the pipe competition, she's out there and the wave comes.
But it's all like horrible CGI.
They essentially just scotch taped her face onto some surfer who doesn't look anything like her.
Oh no.
Crush inspired a ton of girls to get out there and start surfing, and then maybe give it up a week later.
BTW.
Members of Congress, the President of the United States.
In 2002, during the State of the Union address, President Bush tried to scare the shit out of us by coining the phrase "axis of evil."
States like these and their terrorist allies constitute an axis of evil.
The axis of evil were these three countries that were like really f***ed up, and like we decided as Americans, like, I don't think so.
These regimes pose a grave and growing danger.
North Korea, Iran, and Iraq.
I want to know where the axis was though, because like North Korea's like over here and Iran and Iraq are like over here.
The countries had nothing to do with each other. That's like saying the axis of evil is like the Yankees, the Red Sox, and Tony Danza.
Bush's speechwriter David Frum originally wrote axis of hatred, but Bush saw that and was like, nah son, we can punch that up a bit. Let me throw an evil in there.
Axis of evil, much better. He's right, that pops, axis of evil, that pops.
Evil is real, and it must be opposed.
I really didn't understand what he was talking about. I pictured like a lair in the side of a mountain with some villains hanging out at a round table.
Global politics is hard. I just want someone to tell me who the bad guys are and then tuck me into bed with my binkies.
I have my own axis of evil. It's bikini season, calls from debt collectors, and interventions.
Online porn.
People who fart on airplanes.
Carbs.
The movie Titanic.
Pants, having to wear pants.
My wife, her mother, and my mother. Those three b****s are ruining my life.
Thank you all. May God bless.
OMG.
2002 is all about getting hot and hurt.
Nelly's Hot and Her was a huge hit.
This was the jam. How could a guy not like this song? It's encouraging women to get naked.
I said, it's getting hot in here, so, hot. So take off all your clothes.
I am getting so hot, I want to take my clothes off.
It's a genius song, and it worked. I've seen it work. From a distance, I was never involved.
So take it off like you're home alone. You know, dance in front of the mirror while you're on the phone.
I think what inspired the song was me and Pharrell in the studio trying to create a song that, you know, we felt could get the party started. We were a lot younger than we are now. So you would say boys will be boys.
It's getting hot in here.
Nelly was fine, he was sexy, he had a band-aid on his face.
He needs to take some of his clothes off. Let me kiss that boo-boo under your band-aid.
Everybody's using the slang from it. People's walking up to you, you know what I'm saying? Hey, it's getting hot in here.
If somebody says it's hot in here, I will still say, then take off all your clothes. That is how epic Nelly's song is.
Now what should I do?
WTF.
J-Lo plus Ben Affleck equals Bennifer. That was the best celebrity couple maybe ever.
I was obsessed with Ben Affleck and Jennifer Lopez dating. Like, obsessed.
I dated Jennifer's sister for a few years. I was right there, front center. It was a relationship like we'd never seen before.
I thought maybe when we announced it, people would kind of just let it go, but now it doesn't seem like that.
How excited was the Mongoloid that came up with the name Bennifer?
Bennifer really started that trend with putting the names together. You had Brangelina, you had Tomcat, you had Dijonnaise, which is delicious.
I'm hungry.
Ben Affleck is the son of two teachers from Cambridge, Massachusetts. Ben, you don't have the experience, all right? She comes from the South Bronx.
Who knew Ben Affleck was down with all that booty?
I think the reason people really turned on Ben Affleck was in the Jenny from the Block video, he did two butt pats.
You can't do that.
You get one butt pat. Two, you're pushing it.
A little piece of me died when Bennifer was no more.
I was fooled by the rocks that she had. So was Ben.
I thought we'd have a nice quiet life. It didn't turn out that way.
Well, that's okay.
Even though they're not together anymore, Bennifer will still be the ultimate super couple of the 2000s. You'll miss them.
TTYL. Coming up, Serena Williams serves up a can of whoop ass.
She put her electro booty into gear and just like went to town.
And the TV series you got reprimanded for not watching.
It's just one of those TV shows that has a serious cult following, and if you've never seen it, you might as well just die.
Plus, the trendy tracksuit that took over the world.
This is basically a sweatsuit that no woman ever exercises in.
Next on I Love 2002. But first, George Takei's Oh My moment of 2002.
Oh my, oh my, oh my, oh my. King of Pop, Michael Jackson, spent his entire life entertaining the world, winning countless awards and selling hundreds of millions of albums. And in November of 2002, he also dangled his infant son off a balcony. Oh my. What a bad idea. That's your Oh My moment of 2002. See you next year.
She is the 2002 U.S. Open champion and the number one player in the world.
In 2002, Serena Williams just beat the sh** out of any human in tennis.
I mean, this girl was on fire. They called her stint the Serena Slam.
Homegirl won the U.S. Open, the French Open, Wimbledon, and the Australian Open.
That's hard. That's crazy hard. But she put her electro booty into gear and just, like, went to town.
Love me some Serena Williams. The body alone is like, wow. Makes me want to do some squats for the rest of my life so that I can have an ass like hers.
Listen, I got a 5-girl list of girls that I want to suck a fart out their butt, and Serena is absolutely one of those girls who I want to suck a fart out her badunkadunk.
You ever seen a serve of hers? It's over 100 miles per hour. I'm like...
I mean, she had power that, as far as my money goes, she could play with the men.
And on top of that, her wardrobe was a whole nother situation. I mean, she rocked a black cat suit.
People just went crazy.
The cat suit was a real winner.
Serena has created an entire empire. I mean, she's a huge tennis star. She's a model.
Actress, clothing line, part owner of the Miami Dolphins.
Serena did a commercial for McDonald's for a hamburger called the Big and Tasty.
What better word to describe Serena's badunkadunk than big and tasty? Because I would absolutely eat their ass.
Oh, my goodness.
She's incredible. A phenom.
She just has that will inside of her that says she's going to be great, and she is.
FYI.
I thought that Sheryl Crow, Soak Up the Sun, was probably one of the happiest songs ever. Being in the back seat with my girlfriends, we would just sing the song at the top of our lungs.
I would listen to it when I would go running. At the time, I didn't know I was soaking up skin cancer. I thought I was just soaking up the sun.
Sheryl Crow says, "Hey, America, stop working hard. Just soak up the sun."
Easy for Sheryl Crow to say. For us little normal folk, life isn't that easy. We've got bills to pay.
You have a fancy ride, but baby, I'm the one who has the key.
Video was amazing because Sheryl Crow was like, what, like 45, 62? I don't even know. But she looked amazing.
I like her a lot.
Oh, she's so hot in this. And Lance Armstrong got with her just a couple years after this, a lying rubber band salesman with one nut. Seems unfair. Rock on.
LOL. Get ready for 18 people saying the exact same thing. The Wire was the best show in the history of television.
All I did was watch The Wire. I didn't even go to my family's Christmas. They're like, it's Christmas. Like, I don't care. I gotta see what happens with Bubs.
The Wire was a very smart crime drama about a neighborhood in Baltimore.
It's the only show about drugs that's actually better than drugs.
That is some groundbreaking television. And that's saying a lot for me, because that's a show that doesn't have any boobs in it at all.
All of the characters in this show are great, but Omar was everyone's favorite.
It's like, yeah, I know Omar robs people and shoots people, but he's so cool about it.
I think the reason that people loved Omar so much was because he was honest. He didn't hide who he was, didn't make excuses either.
Everybody was so good, and there were so many terrifying characters.
Some of whom were actual people who lived and grew up in the neighborhood depicted in The Wire.
Michael K. Williams. I met him in a club in Baltimore, and he asked me, can I come on set the next day? And I said, why not if I don't have a hangover?
I've never had an intervention for drugs or alcohol, but anytime I go to a party, somebody corners me and tells me about how I have to start watching The Wire.
I'm that ass. That's me.
Have you seen The Wire? As a Wire fan, I try not to judge people who haven't seen The Wire. But if you tell me that you tried watching The Wire and couldn't get into it, I'm judging you. You're a dip.
BRB.
Juicy Couture made its stamp on the world in 2002.
Juicy Couture, a clothing line that may as well be known as the sweat clothes to the stars.
Every celebrity was wearing Juicy Couture. The minute that they were wearing those suits, it spread like wildfire across America.
Jennifer Lopez convinced me that Juicy Couture was the second coming of Christ, so I bought every single Juicy Couture sweatsuit in every single color.
Everywhere you went, people had on the matching Juicy Couture outfit. Well, it's a sea of allure out there.
It's the first sweat clothes that you can go out in public and feel like you're dressed. You feel put together, you feel sexy, you feel great.
Juicy Couture sweatpants are basically a way to wear sweatpants and be comfortable, but still tell the world I'm rich.
I couldn't afford that. Those were expensive.
Paying all that money for a tracksuit.
Wow. Juicy. How much does it cost for me to just touch them?
I wore Juicy Couture to the airport. I wore Juicy Couture to the gym. I wore Juicy Couture to people's birthday parties, barbecues.
Church. I saw them in church.
They feel good when you put it on and feel like little n****s massaging your body. The way the pockets are sewn to make your booty look like it's getting a little lifted, and the way when you zip it up, it look like your titties are sitting up nice.
The key was to unzip the J zipper to right when the cleavage was forming. Then you turn around and on the caboose, it says Juicy.
That's like the greatest invention since the phone.
See, for me, it was like Juicy. It was like, it's juicy, all right.
How's that juicy? You know what's juicy? A big baked chicken with all the skin on it and having somebody else pay for it. That's juicy as f***.
JK.
Coming up, an old man's game becomes new again.
Before this, if you were a fat smoker that wanted to get on ESPN, you had to learn how to bowl.
And
come on, babe, why don't we paint the town?
The movie that brought musicals back into the mainstream.
I loved it. All my gay friends loved it. We lost our damn minds.
Plus, the infamous ad campaign with one simple question.
Can you hear me now?
People related to that. Because I don't know how many times I said it.
Next on I Love 2002. But first.
Yo, what up? It's your man Nelly, and I know hot, all right? And here are the hotties for 2002.
It's getting hot in here.
First up, Brandy, Full Moon hottie. Jessica Alba, Dark Angel hottie. And Kelly Ripa, Regis's perky sidekick hottie. And those are your hotties for 2002. That was a pretty sexy year.
Oh!
I love the 2000s.
Everywhere you look, people are dealing each other in. From basements in the burbs to high-stakes tournaments, poker is definitely blowing up.
I remember when the poker craze happened. I went from a 16-year-old boy who loved theater to like owing a guy named Diamond Jim $10,000.
The whole world all of a sudden was playing an old man's game. Texas Hold'em took the world by storm.
Shuffle up and deal.
This is the World Series of Poker.
Oh, I remember watching poker on TV.
They came out with those whole card cameras, so it was a little peek through the table and you could actually see the hand that they had.
And he starts off with two aces.
When you're the world champion, aces seem to follow you.
Thanks to World Series of Poker, chubby men sitting was finally a sport.
Then I started seeing this flood of actors, actresses, and people that were like poker players all of a sudden.
Of course celebrities were into poker. Who would have a better poker face than someone who's had the life Botoxed out of their face?
How's Shannon Elizabeth gonna play this hand? How does Jennifer Tilly judge the scenario?
Jennifer Tilly has huge breasts. I know that has nothing to do with what we're talking about, but I just wanted to put it out there.
Poker is interesting because the better you are at it, the less you are invited to do it.
Yeah, I'm pretty good at poker.
Reverse. Skip turn. Red 2. Green 6. Boosh.
Card shark.
WTF.
Superman, a 5 for fighting. This song basically has a ponytail.
I can't stand to fly. I'm not that naive.
It is about Superman having his period.
I'm more than a bird. I'm more than a plane.
Really? I'm supposed to feel bad for Superman now? You want to trade live Superman? No, I don't think so. Quit your whining.
I remember hearing this song come on the radio when I was driving after breaking up with my girlfriend and thinking, these guys are not understanding Superman's real power structure, like how he operates.
It was a post-9/11 song, and we all just were like, we're just so sad. You can give us any song right now, we're gonna sing to it and cry.
But I think that at the end of the day, people don't want a mopey Superman. Like, 5 for Fighting should have come out of the song like 5 years later called like, hey, I'm Superman and I'm feeling a lot better.
PTW.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Kids, I want you to travel back in time with me. The year is 2002, and cell phones don't always work. I know, it's weird.
Can you hear me now?
So Verizon runs this ad campaign where a guy's walking around saying, can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
The premise of the commercial was that Verizon's coverage is so good, it doesn't matter where you are, you're not gonna have that call be dropped.
Can you hear me now?
It's the most popular catchphrase for cell phones.
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
You were constantly saying that.
I don't know how many times I said it.
No, my car hit another car. It's on fire. What, huh? No, I need, hello? Can you hear me now?
You would just walk around like an idiot.
Where's reception? We must find it.
I used to have to climb a tree while wearing a tinfoil hat to make a phone call.
Dropped calls was a good thing. Sometimes, like when you're arguing with somebody, you're like, I can't, what, hello, hello, click, because you just didn't feel like talking to their ass.
Can you hear me now?
Paul Marcarelli, the Can You Hear Me Now guy, had that gig for 9 years.
Dude is so rich. Can you hear him now? Counting his money?
Can you hear me now on the island that I bought?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, cha-ching.
Good.
OMG.
Velma Kelly and Roxy Hart. Shouldn't it be alphabetical? That could work.
The movie Chicago just blew my brains out.
I saw Chicago in New York City at the historic Ziegfeld Theater surrounded by gays, and I loved it.
It was a big deal. I mean, because you didn't have A-list actors like Renee Zellweger and Catherine Zeta-Jones just like lining up to do musicals. And after it, it kind of made musicals cooler. Like, everyone loved it.
Renee Zellweger is a trashy little whore who's cheating on her husband and wants to be a showgirl.
Yes, son of a-
She kills her boyfriend, goes to prison, and meets Catherine Zeta-Jones, who's also a trashy whore, but who is a showgirl.
Look, honey, you want some advice? Keep your paws off my underwear. Okay.
For somebody who had just gone through a divorce and was in a deep depression, watching Chicago, I was just like, go, ladies, go. Complain about men, then kill them.
Son of a bitch!
Queen Latifah was so good in that movie because she gave you this, like, undercover lesbian realness of the 1930s.
You think I got you up here just so you can listen to my radio?
And then Richard Gere is singing and tap dancing. Who knew he could tap dance?
Sorry, I couldn't tell you.
But they were all upstaged by Catherine Zeta-Jones, who was on fire.
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz.
She threw herself into that performance. It was insane.
It's hot and it's very fussy. It's jail.
And all that jazz. Gotta have the cheesy smile.
that jazz.
LOL.
Coming up, a way to make cell phone rings even more annoying.
Uncle Ricky, you're the Destiny's Child fan. Turn it off!
And...
I'm not a gold digger.
A famous widow wins millions.
With those knockers? Yeah, that's worth about $89 million to an old man.
Plus, Missy Elliott's stance on grooming.
If you're a fly gal, get your nails done. Get a pedicure, get your hair did.
Every little white girl was going, oh, I'm going to get my hair did. Just kidding, I'm going to the salon.
Next on I Love 2002. But first...
This is the year in Spears. Britney, that is. 2002. It is a sad day in America. The nation mourns the news. Britney and her beau have split. While Justin was busy crying himself a river, our princess of pop turned her talents to the silver screen.
Oh my gosh, it's the funnest thing in the whole world.
Alas, Hollywood was not calling. Her debut film, Crossroads, proved to be a box office bomb, and the sexy starlet won a Razzie Award for Worst Actress. But it wasn't all bad news for Brit. The lovely Southern Belle was named number one on Forbes' Most Powerful Celebrity list. Way to go, Britney. And that was the year in Spears.
I love the 2000s.
I love the 2000s.
This is a substantial victory for Anna Nicole Smith. Her lawyers say she's thrilled.
In 2002, Anna Nicole Smith finally got that $89 million settlement from her dead husband's estate. Boy, was that family angry.
In the 90s, Anna Nicole Smith was a stripper, turned guest model, turned Playboy playmate.
Smith was 26 when she married the 89-year-old tycoon J. Howard Marshall, worth $1.6 billion.
But he was young at heart and a lot of fun. And a breast man, clearly.
But he dies like 13 months into their marriage, which you know Anna Nicole didn't see coming. I mean, she thought they were about to have like a really long life together.
I'm not a gold digger. He was my prince charming.
But those knockers? Yeah, that's worth about $89 million to an old man.
I was on Team Anna. I mean, Marshall's son was already worth hundreds of millions of dollars, and she had to a living mummy for over a year.
Do you know what I've done just for the promise of brunch? I'm not happy about it, but I'm just saying she did it right.
TTYL.
Jimmy Eat World's The Middle is basically just an inspirational song about just getting past what you're going through.
It was like one of those records that we heard everywhere and that you just couldn't help but like come along with. It was a very happy record.
I just remember being at parties and singing this. No one really knows the words to this song, so you just kind of shout the rhythm of the song.
Everything will be just fine.
I mean, I did it wrong. It's backwards. But you know what I mean.
This is one of those pop songs that started at alternative radio and just meandered into the culture of everybody.
It just takes some time, little girl, in a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be all right, all right.
The video for The Middle was great. Unfortunately, my high school parties had a lot more pants and a lot less people.
As a teenager, I never would have gone to a party in my underwear. Primarily because I didn't wear underwear in high school.
All my high school parties was just like fat dudes in flannels staring at two hot chicks that showed up.
It just takes some time.
This is a song that you will hear at every football game that you will go to for the rest of your life. It's just a cannot miss great pop rock song.
FYI.
Before ringtones came out, we only had simple, one-note, boring phone ringing noises. How did we even get by back then?
Finally, we were liberated to annoy those around us by individualizing our phones.
Uncle Ricky, you're the Destiny's Child fan. Turn it off!
I was in high school. Some guys were getting like rap songs as ringtones or pop songs. I had The Hills Are Alive with The Sound of Music. High school was difficult for me.
I got the crazy frog. It's like this frog, and he's like, and he like shook and shaking. That was my ringtone.
I will have. Hello.
I really hate the old-timey ringtone. Because it makes me feel old. It's usually young people that have like, can you believe this? Listen to this. And I'm just like, oh, you mean like my childhood? Ringtone. Why did I
buy the stupid ringtone? It became like a big deal, just acquiring ringtones.
Most of my credit card debt is from downloading ringtones. Still paying it off. Still paying off Light My Fire.
Nowadays, it's like, why do you have your phone on?
Turn that thing off. We don't even want to hear your phone ring in the first place. Vibrate, vibrate.
WTF.
Coming up. The movie that introduced us to the modern zombie.
The plot of 28 Days Later was, holy shit, there are fast zombies coming at me.
And satellite radio takes off for a price.
Radio you pay for, yes!
Next on I Love 2002. But first, Michael Kenneth Williams with the anti-hero of 2002.
The character you've gotta love, even though they don't play well with others. Say, for instance, Omar Little from The Wire. You love me, right? Vic Mackey from The Shield. No one works harder to fight crime than him. Usually by planting evidence, murdering people. Vic did everything the hard way, but I'd rather have him on my side than working against me. That makes Vic Mackey the anti-hero of 2002. And remember, the game is out there. It's either play or get played.
Later is a great movie directed by Danny Boyle. It's just a classic zombie film.
The plot of 28 Days Later was, holy shit, there are fast zombies coming at me.
I can see them, they're coming!
They weren't the slow, plodding zombie. They were like,
are you okay?
I shit my pants.
This is the film that really gave a second wind to zombies. As a serial killer, you know, I'm a little ticked off about that.
They run around like a bunch of coked out weirdos.
Where did this zombie outbreak start? 3 a.m. at Studio 54.
If you got like blood like on one of your pores, you immediately became infected like 30 seconds later. They should have called it 28 seconds later.
Don't look up, cause a bird might drop some zombie blood.
Poop. Zombie poop.
It's a big old zombie in your eye, and then you are f***ed.
There's so much puking of blood in that movie. It's pretty great.
If I was in 28 Days Later, it would have been called 5 minutes from now. That would be me and a bunch of dead zombies.
I think I would survive for approximately 4 minutes, just long enough to eat a pack of Doritos and die.
I love zombie movies, but I'm worried about a zombie apocalypse about as much as I'm worried about Miley Cyrus becoming president. It's a terrifying thought, but highly unlikely.
BRB.
This is a missing element. One time exclusive.
Come on, is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my thing down, flip it and reverse it.
Missy Elliott, Work It, was a masterpiece.
Ooh, I love that song so hard. Is it worth it? Let me work it. Yeah, girl.
If you got a big, let me search it to find out how hard I gotta work, yeah.
It was the best song about a woman looking for a man with a huge Johnson that I've ever heard.
Before you come, I need to shave my
Thanks to Missy Elliott, we all say things like, phone before you come, I need to shave my I mean, Queen Elizabeth says that to Prince Philip.
If you're a fly gal, get your nails done. Get a pedicure, get your hair did.
Every little white girl was going, oh, I'm gonna get my hair did. Just kidding, I'm going to the salon.
Keep your eyes on my boom boom boom.
Yeah, she can work it, you know what I mean? I knew it was a little over the top when she did the split.
Boy, oh boy, it's good to know ya.
I was like, hey, I know Missy can move, but I don't think that she did that.
People thought it was gibberish, but it was actually the song being played in reverse.
Like if you rewound that, it would actually say, put my thing down, flip it, and reverse it.
I just played it over and over and over again, and I'm like, God, why can't I think like this?
JK.
When I heard about satellite radio, I thought it was absolutely ridiculous. Who would pay for something that is free?
Of course I paid for radio, are you kidding me? There's no commercials, there's like 1,000 channels. Maybe I'm in the mood for classic rock. Maybe I'm in the mood for country music, like say if I'd gotten a lobotomy.
It's uncensored, so you can say whatever you want.
You can hear some guy going like, here's that song you like. So it's pretty cool.
Once you get satellite radio in your car, the idea of going back to regular radio is impossible. You just won't do it.
My friends and I never paid for it. We all had cars with like, serious, for a subscription, call, and none of us had any money.
It was kind of dwindling for a while. People didn't want to pay the money.
The struggling broadcaster warned that it might be forced to file for bankruptcy.
Then Howard Stern decided to move his show into satellite radio.
It's a brand new universe. Satellite radio is here to stay.
And completely, single-handedly saved satellite radio.
He has a strong influence in things. Baba Booey!
When he was going over, I was like, fine, take my money, here you go. I'll put one of these things in my car. It looks like a fish finder, but I don't care.
I thought it was a genius. It was worth paying for.
I don't think there's any going back. You can't imagine life without satellite radio.
LOL.
Coming up,
I am a punk. I do live in a trailer with my mom.
Eminem goes the extra mile.
Watching it, you were so engrossed. You were like, damn, this is Eminem.
Next on I Love 2002. But first,
hi, everybody. I'm Brett Michaels, letting you know it's okay to admit you have some serious guilty pleasure issues. Like these gems from 2002. Crank Yankers, Puppets, and Prank Phone Calls. I dare you not to laugh. And Spray Tans, Ladies. I don't care how you get your tan on, just as long as I'm there to inspect the tan lines when it's all said and done. And those are your serious guilty pleasures of 2002. Don't be embarrassed. The first step is admitting it.
I hear you're a real dope rapper.
A dope rapper?
Yeah.
Who told you I was a dope rapper?
You know, it's around.
8 Mile, I love this movie. It was so hardcore. I loved the rapping, I loved the throwing up, I loved the sleeping with the girl in the factory. I loved everything about this movie.
I saw 8 Mile while we were on tour in Boston, and I remember coming out of the theater and being like, it wasn't just okay, it was awesome.
Watching it, you were so engrossed, you were like, damn, this is Eminem.
Who knew he could act? He does a good job, I gotta tell you.
It's a classic American underdog story. You know, it's Rocky with hip-hop music.
Eminem was like the Rocky. Brittany Murphy was like the Adrian. Mekhi Phifer was like the Mickey.
How you feeling?
Feel good.
You feel good?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm ready.
Get black, forget white. It was a hip-hop movie.
It's much cooler than one of these weirdo dance movies. They're not gonna, like, dance each other into a corner. They're gonna rap each other into a corner.
I am a punk. I do live in a trailer with my mom.
This is the first time I saw a real battle rapper make it to the mainstream.
I'm a little too polite for rap battles. Yo, I like those shoes. No, I really do like those shoes. That's a nice outfit you got on. No, seriously.
The movie's theme song, Lose Yourself, won the motherfucking Oscar. And it deserved it. It was an amazing song.
I still hear that song to this day. And I actually want to get up and do something when I hear it.
Everybody
played it to get psyched up for the geometry test or the track meet or I'm gonna ask my teenage pregnant girlfriend to marry me.
You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime.
He's in there and he's rapping and everyone's like, hey, you stop rapping. And he's like, I'm not gonna stop rapping. And everyone's like, he's actually a pretty good rapper.
So Eminem, I mean, he really made white people cool back in 2002.
I dug the movies, cool flick, man.
Eminem.
LOL.
And now, Hal Sparks Millennium Remix, 2002.
Clearly Hal Sparks focusing on his hand.
We finally got ringtones. We got satellite radio.
Can you hear me now?
You thought AM was bad. Drive a tunnel with satellite access.
People wanted to see my life. People wanted to see Nelly.
Hot here this year at the Kids' Choice Awards. Is that weird?
That's so weird.
Just for a game of Old Maid. This game sucks.
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
I think they hung up.
Screw this. We got Anna Nicole Smith. We got Panic Room, a movie that was really about my bathroom.
I think it's very cool that I was born so far. I'm a prince of darkness, right?
Jennifer Tilly has huge breasts.